Hi, in this video, I'll show one way of solving an expected value word problem, and that is to convert the problem into a probability table and work with that. Let's say you're given this word problem. A company sells smart switches. It makes a profit of $4 for every switch, but if the switch turns out to be defective, then you'll have to replace it for the customer and personnel costs and shipping costs, et cetera. And the company will expect to lose $60 on that defective switch. And on average, one out of every 50 switches will be defective, but the company doesn't know which ones are defective until a customer complains. And this is actually rather common because the company would be buying a whole bunch of switches from some source company in some other country. It comes over in a big cargo ship. If the customer orders it, they sell it, send it out, and they have no idea what's inside the box, whether or not it's good or bad, until the customer complains. Question is, can the company expect to make a profit in the long term? It's these words here, can the company expect, that are the indication that this is an expected value problem. So before I work on this problem, let's go back and review expected value. The expected value of a probability distribution is given by this formula, where the Greek letter sigma means to add. You take an x value, you multiply its probability p of x, and you do that for every possible x value, and then you add them together. Typically, we're given a probability distribution in the form of a table like this, and we're asked for the expected value of this probability distribution. Then what we do is create a column of x times p of x. 2 times 0.267 is 0.534. Do it again. 5 times 0.537 is 2.685. And we do it again until the end of the table. Negative 10 times 0.196 equals negative 1.96. Now we add the last column together. Sum of x times p of x is the sum of the last column, and it equals 1.259. The expected value of x is 1.259. Last, the typical expected value problem where you're given the probability distribution in the table format. Now let's go back to example one. Hit pause to read it again. In this case, we don't have a table. There are many ways of solving this, but today I'm showing you how to solve this by creating a probability table from this and then compute the expected value based on that table. First question though, what is the random variable? Where in all the words of the problem can we find the random variable x? And the way to find the random variable is to look at the question prompt. Ask ourselves, what value are we expecting? And the answer here is we're expecting the value of the profit. So profit is the random variable. Therefore, we should make a table where x equals profit, p of x is the probability, and a column where we multiply x times p of x. But I'll tell you right now, don't just do that. You should put in an extra column for description of the situation, so that you can keep track of all the different situations that come up, all the different x values that come up and their probabilities. So do a table like this instead. Have an extra column of workspace in front. We'll use it to describe the situation so that we can link the x and the p of x correctly. There we go. First column is the situation. Second column is x, which in this case is the profit. Third column is p of x, and then the fourth column is x times p of x. Now let's fill it in. What are the possible values of x, the profit? Here's one possible profit. X could be $4 in profit. So put that in, x equals 4. But also put in the description. This is important. The company gets a profit when the switch works. So write that down in the table. What other possible profit value? Here's another. It doesn't say the word profit. It actually says lose $60, but that's the same as a negative $60 in profit. So you got to read carefully and critically on every word of the word problem. So put in negative 60 in the profit column for that situation and put in the description of when it is that we'd lose $60. That would be when the switch is defective, right? Defective in the first column. Now fill in the blanks for the probabilities P of X. Read through the problem and look for where it says anything that sounds like a probability. Here's something, 1 out of every 50 switches. That's a probability of 1/50, but where do we put it? This is where the first column becomes helpful. 1 out of 50 switches will be defective. That means the probability of 1/50 should go under defective, like this. Now there's just one more probability to go. Since the total probability has to be 1, we know what has to go in there. 1 out of 50 are defective, so 49 out of 50 are good. Great, we're done setting up the table. All we need to do is multiply X times P of X and then add them. 4 times 49/50, -60 times 1/50, add that last column equals 2.72. The expected value of the profit is 2.72, which is a positive number. So yes, the company can expect to make a profit in the long term, a positive profit of 2.72. Write down the answer. This is very important. Always answer the question asked. You cannot do a bunch of calculation and just leave it. All right, are we good? Okay, let's now summarize and apply it to another example. Step one, determine what's the random variable. To answer that, read the question prompt. What is it asking us to compute? We're computing the expected value of what? Step two, make a table with 4 columns. Situation, X, P of X, and X times P of X. Step three, fill in the X's, but also a brief description of the situation that goes with each X. Step four, fill in the P of X's. Use the description of the situation to compute the P of X and put it in the right place. Step five, compute X times P of X, and then add them together to get expected value of X. Example two, you throw a fair die. If it comes up 4, 5, or 6, you win the face value of the die in dollars. If not, you lose $3. In the long run, should you play this game? As you read the problem, make sure you understand it. What is the situation and what's going on? What happens if you throw a 1? What happens if you throw a 2? How about a 3? How about a 4? How about a 5? How about a 6? Think about what's going on there so that you can do the problem. Hit pause and try to do the problem. To start, try to figure out what is the random variable. Welcome back from the pause. Step one, what is the random variable? Read the question prompt. In the long run, should we play this game? Well, that doesn't help, at least not right away. And that means a lot of these problems require you to dig a little deeper. Should I play this game? I mean, how would I decide whether to play this game? So think about that a little bit. Yeah, well, if I expect to win, I would play the game. If I expect to lose, then forget it. Therefore, it's really about the expectation of winning, right? Losing is just negative winning. So the expected value that I'm looking for is the expected value of the winning. Therefore, the random variable is the winning amount. Now let's make a table. I know I want these 4 columns, the situation, the X, which now I know is the winning, the probability of X, and the multiplication X times P of X. I really don't know how many rows I need, so I just give myself a whole bunch. First, fill in the X's. What are the possible winning values? Here it is. One possible winning value is the face value. We need numbers, so what are the face values? Well, it happens when I roll a 4, 5, or 6, so the face values are 4, 5, or 6. So I fill those into the table. Now, what situation goes with these? Well, you win $4 when the die comes up 4. So write that in. And then similarly for 5 and 6. There we go. Any other winnings? Yep, here it is. A loss of $3, which is a winning of negative three. Put that in. Now I need the description of the situation. When is it that I lose $3? It says, if not what? If I don't roll a four, five, or six, meaning if I roll a one, two, or three. So put that in there. Now the probabilities. What's the probability of x equals four? And this is where the first column helps, right? X equals four when the die rolls a four. And that probability is one out of six. So we get that probability in there. Now hit pause and finish this problem. Welcome back from the pause. You should have the table like this. And then you add the x times p of x column and you should get 1.8333. The expected winning is $1.83. Since it's a positive number, the answer is yes, you should play this game. Again, important, write the answer down. Answer the question asked. Yes, I should play this game, or you should play this game, because in the long run, I would win $1.83 per game. I hope that helps. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more content. Bye.